Hello students, today we will discuss about three different things into the CSS. First one is CSS ID selector, second one is CSS class selector and CSS grouping selector. All these three things we will discuss in this particular video. Okay, for that first I will go with the CSS ID selector. But before going to the ID selector, we have to understand exactly what we have done. See, in the compared to previous video, I have made one modification into this. What I have done is I have set one paragraph tag here. With this, what happens is with this particular paragraph tag here, you can see I have set it to font family Vandana and font size 20px. Correct? Okay. Now, by doing that, if I save the file and show it in the browser, the paragraph will look like this. So if you don't have this tag, what will be the paragraph? I will just show you that. So I will remove this. Okay, then I will save the file, then I will just demonstrate it. So it was looking like this. Now it is changed. Now I want to do it using ID. Means here, as I mentioned, we will discuss about three factors. Now first I will show you how we can have a ID selector, how we can define the ID selector using CSS. I will just paste that, and instead of P, I will take it as P is a paragraph tag, correct? I will take it as hash. So here I have to use hash P1. Hash P1. Okay. Now I will save it. I will save the file and I will refresh it. So nothing has come here, right? Now I will just what I have to do, that is the question. Correct. For paragraph tag, what I will do is I will just use id equal to p1. Id equal to p1. Let me check whether it gives or not. Okay. Control S, save. Now you see this changed. Correct. So what you can do is, in the previous video we had directly used p at p as a attribute, p as a class name here, but here I have used hash p1, that will be id. So if even I can change a name here, par, if I change para 1 here id I have to give para 1. Okay, control S, save it and refresh. Something else if you try, par, control S, it will come to the point. So properly you have to define. So this is how you can go with the id. Once we go with the ID selector, next let us see about the class selector. Means now what we have done is we have defined para 1 as a ID. Now what I want to do is I want to define it as a class. Now in case you want to define it as a class, these are different ways of defining this. Here I had used hash, right? Here I had used dot, a period, okay, para 1. But when you define it as a class, this is when you define it like this, it becomes a class. Okay, now here instead of id you have to use a keyword called as a class. So if you use a keyword class in colon equal to, you have to use para para. Okay, now I will save the file and I will just refresh it. So now it is defined as a class. For this one also I will change, I think also I will change, because I want to make this as a class. H1 I want to make it as a class. So here what I will do is dot add 1, and I will change this font here. I will make it Vandana like this. Okay, I want to change it, where I will make it is Times New Roman, correct? I have changed it. Now I have saved a file. Yeah, just a minute, I have to make a class here, H1. I have to define it as a class, where you can see Sublime Text automatically it comes, where you can see automatically para 1 is coming, C. Can you see behind this it is indicating C. So this is a class what is available. So you can, this is the advantage of using the Sublime Text. See, font I have defined. Here font size is defined. Now I can increase the pixel size, in case I want to increase the size. Okay, so I will make it as 80 pixels. 80 pixel, font name, control S. Now let me check. something went wrong here. I don't know what is the problem. Head one, something like that. I will just remove this. I don't want to make it a problem. Save the file. There is some issue here. Okay, here you can see actually I have taken some time to correct the problem. So what is the problem? I understood here, I just changed the things here. I made a font as a Vardhana, then font size is a 20px. So sometime problem may come, but I have identified where is the problem. See here, what happened is here you can see I have defined it as a head 1, correct? Now here you can see here I have given it as a para 1. So here I should have changed it to head 1. So sometime we might make a mistake, we are also human beings. So I have made a change here, control S. Now I will just go through it. Yeah, now it is coming correctly. I want to increase the size of this. It has become 20 pixel. Now I have given it as a 20 pixel. I have copied it from the paragraph only. So I will make it, so same size it has taken, I will make it 50 pixel. Okay. And this is how you have to make the changes and see the things. See, this is how you can make a modification in different tags according to your requirement. So this was the second case, that is we discussed about the second factor, that is a class selector. Now we will discuss about grouping selector. In case you want to do it for multiple, so what I can do is I can just go with grouping the things. So here for that I have to change the object. Here I will make it as a H1 heading, and I will just remove from class from the existing only. I am just changing it here. Then I will make it as a comma P. Okay, and I will set the size for this. And this I will remove. So what I have done, I have taken it in two groups. One I have taken it as a heading, and another one I have taken it as a paragraph. For both I have set the same thing. So I will just for demonstration I am doing this. And now I will save the file and I will do this. See, same thing is done. Right? Now what I will do is I will modify this and I will show you. See, both H1 and P are having the same format, but H1 is coming with the bold letter. So I will just change it pixels here. So I will just for reference I am doing this, correct? So for both I have taken same, I have reduced the size. Both are, both sides are reduced. So this is how you can control your document with, in this fashion. So now in this video we have learned about the three different concepts. One is the ID tag, where we are simply writing along with the attribute. Here we are using the directly, here we are using along with this ID, we are writing ID equal to char. That is the first thing we have done. Second, we have done it with the class. And third thing is we have done it in H1 P1. So when you write it H1 and P1, I just once again made a mistake here. You should, it is not necessary to write it here. Just simply write H1 and P1. Okay? Okay, control S. Now refresh. This is sufficient. Okay, this is how you can write the code. I hope you got a better idea about these three different ways of defining the CSS. Thank you for watching this.